It's Sonny and Finn's Wrestling and Video Game Podcast. This week, we talk about the usual wrestling and video game news, and we give our thoughts on SummerSlam and NXT Takeover Brooklyn 2.
What's up, guys? Welcome to episode 27 of the Sonny and Finn Show. I'm Sonny, and I'm one of your hosts, and with me, as always, the king of strong style, Finn Steele.
Hello.
How are you?
Very good, thank you. How are you?
I'm good. Do you feel like the king of strong style?
Yeah, sure.
Yeah.
Why not?
It's hot again.
It's so hot. Why is it so hot?
Well, I can't sleep. This is too hot.
Me too. Bloody weather.
I just can't handle it. Like, I have to have like the tiniest quilt. I may as well have like a sheet of tissue paper covering me at night because I can't deal with the heat.
Yeah, I always have my like hand blowing on me. That's like half the covers off, mostly covers off, just and then laying there in my pants.
What a lovely image.
You're
for
welcome.
Everybody out there.
You're welcome, internet.
It's the same for me. When the Sonny and Finn calendar for 2017 comes out, that's going to be one of the images.
Yeah, some is just going to be me covered up by a duvet. I'm laying in my bed. It's not here.
Pants.
Yeah. You're welcome, ladies.
All men.
All men, sure, why not?
We're not like that on this podcast.
Yeah, we're all inclusive. Even.
Yeah, sure. Don't anyone out. This is a good start.
It is.
I think because you know, like, wrestling has eras.
It does.
So we're in the PG era at the minute.
Yeah.
I think we're still in that anyway, I'm not sure.
I think so.
We had the Attitude Weird. Era. If our podcast was to have an era, it'd be the weather era.
The weather era, yeah. The too bloody hot era.
Yeah, like the heat wave era.
Yeah.
Something to do with weather.
Yes. Sun era.
Because like, it seems like we start every week complaining about the weather.
We do, yeah.
Like, I don't know what it's going to be like in a couple of months' time when it's like November and getting cold and we're sitting here shivering.
Yeah, it's bloody cold. I wish the sun was back up.
Yeah. The Sonny and Finn Wrestling Video Game and Weather Podcast.
Yeah, that's it. That's a new name, yeah. I'm changing the logo and everything.
Yeah, do it.
Yeah.
We could have like be like the actual weather, so you know, like them logos they have for to signal rain.
Oh yeah,
which is like a cloud and a raindrop.
Yeah,
you have them, not the sunshine.
Not good. I've laced the wrestlers with that, like 8-bit wrestlers with that in our logo.
Okay, that sounds good.
Cool. That's gonna be our cover for this episode. It's a rain cloud.
These things they just create themselves.
They do, do they?
They absolutely do.
Good stuff.
We are the Sonny and Finn Show. We are a video game and wrestling podcast that posts every single Friday.
Yes.
On iTunes, SoundCloud, and every other podcast service.
We're everywhere.
That you can get.
You can't escape us.
You can't escape us.
YouTube, everything.
Everywhere.
Dailymotion, we're not, but we could be.
We're not on Dailymotion.
Could be if we wanted to.
Everywhere else. We're not on Spotify, but we're everywhere else. Or Google, because it doesn't allow it in this country yet.
Yeah, it's weird, annoying.
But we're everywhere else.
Everywhere else. Everywhere we can possibly be.
Yes, everywhere we can be, we are.
We are that word, yeah.
What?
Omnipotent?
That's big words.
Yeah, big words are hard, I don't know.
Yeah, big words are hard.
I need to book more.
You need...
I need more book. In my life.
We've got two big books here. We've got three, four big books there.
Whoa.
None of which are going to teach us really anything of any use.
Not really. We've got the WWE Encyclopedia, DC Comics something or other.
Encyclopedia. You just read that word.
No, I mean, there's one above it, which is year by year something.
Oh, it's a visual chronicle.
Ah, that's what it is.
Yeah.
And underneath that, we've got the Marvel Chronicle. So, yeah, good stuff.
And the DC Comics Encyclopedia as well, that's there.
And that one, yeah, yeah.
So you can see books. That we're into intelligent reading.
I've got only the best books in this house.
Although comics do have sophisticated stories in it.
They do. That's true.
It's not like it's War and Peace.
No.
Or, you know, other books with a lot of words. Like the Bible is the only other one I can think of. On the top of my head, the Bible is the only other one.
Honestly, a comic book adaptation of the Bible.
Yeah?
Yeah, I think that'd be a thing.
Do you think Jesus would have a lot of muscles?
Yeah, not the muscliest looking...
He wouldn't,
dude.
Wouldn't he? Do you think he'd have a J on his robe?
Yeah, some big J.
Just a massive... What do you
think? JC.
What's his superpower?
I don't know. He's got all the superpowers, isn't he? He's Jesus. He can do what he wants.
That's true. He's like the greatest superhero of all time.
Pretty much.
Yeah. Like, the Avengers are... Like, this is... I'm obviously talking... AD.
Sure. Shrug.
I don't know. I mean, I was sucked at RE. Like, so bad.
Oh, yeah, I see what you mean, yeah. Yeah, me too.
Anno Domini.
I got a D in GCSE.
Already. I got a U.
Really? Wow.
Yeah. I don't think I went, actually. I think that's the...
I just was there. I was there to watch, like, the weird movies we'd watch every now and again.
We there to watch Passion of the Christ.
Yeah.
Did he show you that movie? I think we watched probably. That movie.
Yeah.
That's the Mel Gibson movie.
Oh, yeah, I think
it's. I don't think he's in it. I think he directed it.
Something like that. I don't know. Some Jesus-y movie.
Jesus-y,
yeah, you know.
Was it The Nativity?
Just the Nativity play. On a
who did you play in The Nativity at school? We're not even Christmas yet, we're talking about this.
I didn't.
You didn't?
No.
I was the very festive character of a Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle.
Nice. Nice.
You remember that from the Bible, right?
Of course, yeah.
Yeah.
When turtles came and beat everyone. Like, cowabunga, dude.
Yeah. So, they were Jesus' first words as well.
Yeah. Cowabunga.
We've made religion.
Yeah.
Today, right here.
And Jesus said unto Daniel, cowabunga, dude.
Yes. Unto Daniel.
Daniel. I don't know. I don't know how Bible words work.
Okay.
Yeah.
It would like have, like, I imagine it's like Game of Thrones. Like, hath and thou and
those words. So. All I know is Austin 3:16 said, I just kicked your ass.
That is all the Bible that you need to know.
Yeah, exactly. That's all I know. That's all you need to know.
Yeah, I agree. That is all you need to know.
The wrestling Bible.
Yeah. I'm like a wrestling Bible. I think we've established this over the weekend.
You are living wrestling Bible.
I feel like I am a little bit.
Feel the useless wrestling knowledge.
and that's exactly what it is. It's not even like... There I am. Like, they were talking about sort of... do love and stuff on the stream, and I just start reeling off like the pay-per-views that it was from and the rivalry. It's like,
does it? What's your favorite SummerSlam match? And I was like, which match was SummerSlam with the CM Punk scene? No. And you were like, oh, this year was this, and this year was that, and we like this year, well, this one from this year. And I was like, how do you know? How do you remember this stuff?
I don't know. It's like I sucked at school so bad, right? I was just like, only because I was just acting like a little idiot.
Yeah,
right?
School's bollocks anyway.
Yeah. Agreed. I think I learned more after school than I did while I was at school.
Yeah, same here. I taught myself more than school ever taught me.
Too busy dicking around at school.
Yeah.
Too busy having fun with my friends.
Yeah.
Being a child.
But yeah, exactly.
I have an okay job.
Yeah.
And I feel like I'm cleverer now than I was then.
Yeah, I think so.
So who's the winner? Who's the real winner here?
Yeah.
I don't think it's the school system. Losers.
Yeah, if you listen to the SoundCloud podcast with Dean Ambrose, his views on school were very similar to mine growing up.
You are a lot less awkward than Dean Ambrose.
You think so?
I think so.
Shocking. Yeah, I'm pretty awkward.
Yeah, but I don't think you're Dean Ambrose awkward. Like, Dean Ambrose literally wanted to talk about nothing.
Yeah, that's true.
It's, so Dean, yeah, how are you?
Yeah, I'm alright.
It's like an episode of Beavis and Butthead.
Yeah, pretty much.
Just want to thank everybody
for sticking with us this long.
Sticking with us for 8 minutes of real nonsense.
Yeah.
First of all, so if you've gotten here, congratulations and thank you. But we just want to thank everybody who came along to our streams.
Yes.
On Saturday for NXT Takeover Brooklyn 2,
mm-hmm.
which was great once it got going.
Yeah, really good.
Finished really strong, so thank you for that. And SummerSlam, which from the start was just phenomenal, and we sort of ended up with near to 800 comments.
Yeah, crazy.
In the chat, and it was really great. So we've picked up a load of new subs as well. So if you are new to us, thank you, and if you've been with us from the start and are still with us, thank you very much as well.
Yes.
And last week's podcast was also the most successful podcast that we've had so far.
Yep, yep.
So thank you very much for that as well.
And thanks to Gaming Mule for coming on with us.
Yes, and we'll have him back on as well.
Yes, absolutely.
We're going to do a special top 10 of the current generation podcast.
Yes,
and
top 10 so far.
We're going to get a couple of guests on to talk to us about that.
Sounds good.
Let's talk video games.
Okay.
What have you been playing since last Wednesday when we did our last podcast?
I've been playing the brand new Deus Ex Mankind Divided, which is a lot of fun.
Mm.
Only played the opening mission and a little bit after that. Trying to get some idea or whatever. But yeah, it's a lot of fun. It's a lot of the first game. But they've done sort of the Metroid-y thing of giving you all your powers to start with and then having something happen and take them away. So you have to like rebuild and give you new powers and stuff like that.
Yeah.
Which I like a lot. It's a cool little framing device. And it's fun. I love it.
Yeah, it's really good. I've played it as well. I've only played basically the same amount as you. It's like, I think I'm literally probably 15, 20 minutes ahead of you.
Yeah.
Cool. I love the setting. I love the main character. I think he's cool. He looks awesome. He's just, just looks cool.
I never asked for this.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And he's just like, he's got one of them voices where he's just like, I don't really, he's like, he's got one, it's just like, feels so relaxed.
Yeah.
So I love the main character. I love the setting. I love the way, it reminds me a lot of, Chronicles of Riddick in the sense of it's a first person shooter, but when you're climbing ladders and doing the melee stuff, it cuts to third person. You see your character do that.
Yeah.
And I've got a lot of time for that. I like it a lot.
Yeah, Chronicles of Riddick was awesome, yeah.
Chronicles of Riddick was a really good game.
Yeah, yeah.
Seriously. Like, it's like a, that's a real sleeper.
Yeah, for sure. They even made it on the 360, didn't they?
They did. Yeah. But like, that's a, it's like one of them games that you don't expect to be good.
Yeah, exactly. Like, so maybe tie in, it's like, oh, this is going to be rubbish.
Because it was an Xbox exclusive, wasn't it? The first Xbox.
I think so.
I remember seeing it for the first time. I was like, shit, this is like actually good.
Yeah, an actual game.
Movie tie-ins suck.
Excuse me.
Bless you.
Thank you.
You okay? You got a cold coming?
I don't know. Hope not.
Oh. I don't I hope not either. I don't want to be ill again.
Yeah, yeah. That would suck.
Yeah.
Sniff.
Yeah. but yeah, Mankind Divided is excellent. I'm looking forward to sort of diving back into it. I'm going to carry on a little bit later on tonight.
Cool.
And yeah, I'm going to put a lot of hours into it, I think, until, you know, until Pro Evo and all them sort of games come out.
Awesome.
Take my interest away.
Yeah,
not interest away, way. But just, you know.
Yeah.
Take my attention for a little while.
Yeah.
I had chance to, like everyone else, had chance to check out the Titanfall 2 tech demo.
Yeah.
Did you try it?
No, I didn't get a chance.
Okay, well, it runs this weekend as well, so you can download it and you can play it this weekend too.
Cool.
It was good. It was more of the same with some new bits.
Great.
So there's a grappling hook. The Titans seem to take a little longer to cook.
Okay.
Than they did before. I don't know if that's just the game modes that are on there.
Yeah, maybe.
But it's good. I liked it a lot. Played a few hours and it's Titanfall.
Yeah.
It's Titanfall with new bits and that's all I can say for it. But that isn't a bad thing.
No. No, first one's cool. I'll try it this weekend. Sounds fun.
Yeah, cool. We'll play together. We'll play it on, I've got it on Xbox, but I'm happy to download it on PS4.
Cool.
If you would play it, rather play it on PS4.
Yeah, well, I'm good either way, honestly.
Okay, have you been playing anything else?
Anyone, No Man's Sky, slogging through it, getting all the trophies and whatnot.
How long have you played now?
I've lost track at this point.
I think it's one of those games where you can lose track because you don't, because you spend so much time, wandering around the planets and doing the stuff and it's so relaxing. No pressure in the game at all.
Yeah.
Have you experienced any stress or pressure from the game?
Not really. I did land on the planet recently. It just gave me like an instant 5-star, well, wanted level. That's like it would be on GTA, but
for the drones.
Yeah, it's super hostile and it's like this big thing. It looked really, really like ominous, but I killed it in like 5 seconds. That was the thing. And but yeah, it's other than that, yeah, it's super peaceful and just
it's a breeze and it's been getting. Like we said last week, it's dividing opinion.
Yeah.
I haven't played it for a few days. But I don't feel like I need to rush through it. It's not one of the things that I'm breaking my neck to do.
Yeah, exactly. It's just play it at your own pace.
Yeah.
There's no rush.
Anything else, or is that it?
That's about it.
Yeah. I haven't been playing much. We've played a ton of WWE 2K16 over the weekend.
Yeah, seriously.
I'm glad to have a break from it until Backlash.
Yeah.
And that's exactly what I'm going to do. I'm going to take a break from it until Backlash.
Cool. Wouldn't blame you.
Because we've played a ton of it this week.
Yeah, so much.
I'm ready for the new one. I really am.
Same. Not long to wait now.
No. A couple of months. Just over.
A little bit.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But yeah, I've not really been playing much else. Played the Titanfall tech test. Played the PES 2017 demo, which I'm a big fan of.
Sweet.
And we're going to stream it after we've finished recording this podcast.
Yep.
Simply because, like last week, I want to know your verdict on it. As a non-football fan, a non-sort of football game-playing person, as a gamer.
Yeah, yeah as from like, from
as
like
opposed a to a sports fan.
Yeah, from like a pure video game standpoint.
Yeah, from a technical standpoint.
Yeah, that's cool. Yeah.
Yeah.
I can do that.
There's some gaming news this week. Not a great deal, just little bits, really. Nothing sort of major's happened.
Slow week.
It is a slow week.
For gaming, anyway.
Yeah, I mean, God, there's wrestling news to go on forever.
Yeah, seriously.
The PS4 Slim has leaked.
Oh.
It looks, it's the PlayStation 4, but it looks different.
Right.
Okay, that's it.
Sounds good.
They're going to announce it from what I believe, alongside the PlayStation Neo, mm-hmm. in quotes.
Cool.
At the press conference in September, so next month. So not long to wait. It's leaked now. Apparently somebody has actually bought one off Gumtree.
Right, okay.
And also CEX have a listing for it where they will buy one off you for £305 and then sell the unit at £380.
Right.
Now, bear in mind, I don't know where they've had their pricing from. Bear in mind this console hasn't actually officially been announced. So how it's out there in the wild, it must be a demo unit or something like that. I don't know.
It must be, yeah, like a dev kit or something.
Yeah, I don't know. But there's one out there. There must be some out there in the wild somewhere. It's not really surprising because Microsoft, not that they're out in the wild. I mean, like, that this is a thing.
Yeah.
There's an Xbox One S, which is gorgeous. Still love it.
Yeah, it's pretty looking machine.
Do you think Neo is going to be pushed back to next year now to compete with Project Scorpio?
I don't think it's to compete with Scorpio, but I do think we won't see it until next year. Because they're leaving it a bit late if it's coming this out this year. They need to get people, please give it time to get people excited for it and stuff. I don't know.
Yeah, look, I'm excited for Scorpio and I'll get one next year.
I probably won't with the Scorpio. I might get a Neo, depends. I don't know. Depends what's
new. We literally know nothing. There's nothing official. Exactly. We know that these things are coming. We don't know anything about them.
Yeah.
We'll know more in September and of course we will report it then.
Absolutely.
Inside. Which was an Xbox exclusive for not very long at all.
Yeah.
Is now available on PS4.
That was fast.
Really fast. That was much faster than I was expecting it to come out.
Yeah, honestly, if I'd have known it was coming out this fast, I would have just waited and bought it on PS4.
There's no Platinum Trophy.
Is there not?
Nope.
Screw that then.
It's weird. It's like there's 1,000 gamer score, which is the most you can get on an Xbox game.
Yeah.
But no Platinum Trophy.
Weird. It's considering like Pac-Man has Platinum Trophy. Like original 8-bit Pac-Man.
Or
like,
what, on the arcade classics re-releases?
Yeah.
What is it?
There's Platinum Trophy, yeah. It's like, why isn't it inside? It's weird.
Very strange. But either way, that wasn't on Xbox exclusively for very long at all.
It wasn't, no. Kind of seemed pointless.
But if you want to go and play it, I loved it. Finn didn't. Yeah. I do recommend it.
Yeah, it's a thing.
Okay.
Easy trophies. No Platinum, but it's easy trophies nonetheless, I guess.
Now, on the flip side of that,
okay,
The Witness, which was a PlayStation 4 exclusive and has been for, what, a few months now?
Yeah, good while.
It's coming to Xbox One on September the 13th.
All right, good.
The Witness is a fancy puzzle game.
Fancy.
It's like a first-person puzzle game, that's what it is.
Pretty much.
Very unique sort of game. Yeah, I've played probably about an hour of it on share play with a friend.
Oh yeah.
And it is really, really good. It's not my kind of game and I don't have the time to dedicate to it, but if you do have the time to dedicate to it and love puzzles and want a challenge, then I would absolutely recommend it. Have you played it?
I haven't. I want to because it is my type of game. I like all this puzzly stuff. But yeah, I don't know. I need time to actually sink my teeth into it, I think. Because it's a big game and yeah.
It's a huge game.
Yeah, I want to give it the attention it deserves.
Yeah, fair enough.
Yeah. Put it on sale, please. And I'll buy.
I imagine it will go in the sale at some point.
Oh, yeah,
sure. Did it come out this year on PS4? I think it did.
Yeah, I think it's short start of the year, in January sometime. Yeah.
Christmas sale. I think you're laughing.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
I love the Christmas sales on PSN.
Yeah, they're good, aren't they?
Bank doesn't.
Yeah, Bank.
I just pick games up that I have no intention of playing.
Yeah. Look, all these games I own and I will never play.
Yeah. Look at these games that I've played an hour of.
Yeah.
That's basically what my game collection is, to be honest.
Same here.
Microsoft have released an Xbox onesie.
Oh, yeah. I saw that. Was that Xbox Australia or something?
Don't know.
Oh.
I saw it earlier on today and I was like, okay, I want one.
Yeah, sure.
It's so the pockets are big enough to carry an Xbox One controller.
Of course.
Well, I've got a list in front of me here. Enlarged pockets to fit an Xbox One controller and media remotes.
I think I'll look at the same list, yeah.
Arm pouch for a mobile phone.
Okay.
Rollable leg and arm sleeves.
Sure.
Forearm grips to prevent slipping.
Slipping on what?
Banana skins.
Oh, of course, yeah. Only forearm.
Oh, yeah. Did you ever think of that? Well, you never know.
He's walking around with a forearm. Oh, no, banana skin. Whoop.
Hey. If gorillas bought a Xbox onesie, that would absolutely be a problem.
It would, yeah. You have a point. Xbox onesie for gorillas.
Maybe that's what they're built for. I mean, there's a man and a woman modelling them on the picture. Extra large hood to accommodate headsets.
Okay, makes sense.
Customised gamertag embroidery.
Fancy.
Now, I asked Microsoft if we could have one earlier.
Nice.
They didn't get back to me, surprisingly. No. I also asked them if we could have a job.
Because they're basically our best friends on Twitter.
They are, yeah. They if we tweet about Xbox, like they all tweet us, like the official Xbox account.
Yeah,
so
weird.
Today, I tweeted them from our account and said, considering we tweet each other all the time, can we have a job?
Mm-hmm.
Or can you sponsor us? Or can we have an Xbox onesie each?
Yeah, yeah.
Or all three?
Or all the above, yeah. Yeah. Definitely.
They haven't got back to me yet. No. I'm sure they've sent that job that official job application to Mr. Gates.
For sure, yeah, I'm sure.
Who is probably going to listen to this podcast and think, those guys are very good. I'm going to sack Major Nelson, and I'm going to sack AC Bongos, and I'm going to employ these two young studs.
Sounds good to me.
He's going to use those words too. He's actually going to use those words. Consider yourself a young stud?
Sure.
Yeah. Why not? I consider you a young stud.
Thank you. Okay. I think.
No, that's fine.
But seriously, hire us, please, Microsoft.
Yeah, sure. I'll sell out.
Yes.
I love my PlayStation. I do.
Me too.
I am preferring my Xbox because my gamer score means more to me.
Okay.
So take that, you know, in my job application. Take that into consideration. Finn has a big gamer score.
Yeah, I do.
Okay,
there's something else then. He has a big gamer score. Oh yeah.
I don't want to lie to everyone.
Well, you know.
We stoop that low that we have to have dick jokes on here.
Yeah, well, you got to stick them in somewhere.
This podcast has had everything so far.
It has.
It's had the Bible.
Mm-hmm.
Dick jokes.
The two.
Christmas.
Christmas.
Weather.
Mm-hmm.
Video games, and some wrestling as well.
Sweet.
And books.
All the books. Good show.
It's like we are the most diverse podcast possibly on the entire internet.
Yeah, pretty much. We talk about everything here. It's only
a
thing.
Yeah, we're labeled as a video game and wrestling podcast, but in truth, we are men of the world.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We are. All inclusive.
That's what it should be called. Welcome to Sonny and Finn All Inclusive.
Yeah.
Oh, this is good.
This podcast is weird.
Every podcast is weird. It's not even up for debate anymore.
Yeah, pretty much.
Like every week, this is like a stupid fucking podcast. we talk about nothing.
Yeah.
We talk about like some of the things that we are labeled to talk about.
Yeah, we have a list of things to talk about. As long as you get them in somewhere.
Yeah, and like it's the rest of it is just padded out.
Yeah,
like last week's was an hour and 45. I'm not even sure what it was filled with.
Yeah, good question. Yeah, just more nonsense.
Tell me about this Dark Souls 3 DLC that's coming out.
It's coming out.
Oh my good, that's really good.
Yeah, it's coming out. It's going to be on the Xbox One, PS4. It's Dark Souls.
PC.
PC. Yeah, as well.
Who cares about PC?
No one plays on PC anymore. Come on, let's be honest.
No, if you do play on PC, then I'm not sure why you do.
People are mad.
Right, it's called Ashes to Arendelle.
Yep.
Ariandel?
Arendelle.
I think it's A-R-I-A-N-D-E-L.
Yes.
Do you realise how long that took me to read out then? It's like...
A for apple. Yeah. Apple. Red. Arendelle.
Okay, we don't know how to pronounce it. Ashes to Something DLC is coming the 25th of October. Is there a season pass for Dark Souls in it?
Yeah, there is. Yeah, it's not.
Jesus fucking Christ. Every game has... I'm surprised Pac-Man re-release hasn't got a season pass.
Yeah, you can now get different coloured ghosts.
I was about to say the exact same thing. It's like we're connected.
My God. You can read my mind.
Yes, yeah. Maybe that's the only thing that you could possibly get for download on Pac-Man.
Pretty much, yeah.
New coloured ghosts. Jesus. Still better than Call of Duty Ghosts.
Yep.
I
thought you liked that one.
I do like that one.
You do?
But Pac-Man is awesome.
It is awesome.
Pac-Man Championship Edition is amazing.
It is, yeah. DX, I think it's called.
Yeah, it's awesome. There's a new one coming out as well.
Oh, sweet.
Yeah. It's got a really original name.
Oh, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
DX2?
Yep.
Sweet.
Yeah.
Perfect.
You know, I've near enough covered everything I had gaming wise, but Xbox games with gold for September have been announced.
Okay.
I like this month.
Okay.
I like every month. I think Xbox has done a really good job with games with gold since like they started doing it.
They have, yeah.
Because PlayStation Plus is...
It's a bit hit and miss.
We're literally paying to play online because I don't ever download any of them games.
Yeah, well, we had Yakuza 5 this month, didn't we? That's pretty cool.
Yeah, fuck awesome. You. If you've got a PS3, that's fine.
Yeah, good for me. Yay.
Give us Yakuza 0 next year, then we're talking.
Yeah, yeah, that'd be good.
That's not going to happen. But
nope, nope, never happen. Maybe in like 2 years.
Well, I'm not waiting that long. I've waited this long for it to be translated and to come out in English.
Yeah, seriously.
I've still got months to wait now.
Yeah, never.
There'll be no podcasts during them few weeks. I'm just going to explain that.
Yeah.
Okay, back to the games with gold. $74 worth of games.
Sweet.
That is some amount of money in English pounds.
Yeah.
It's 4,000 gamer score on offer.
Nice.
I like that they do that.
That's cool. Pretty cool, actually.
All right, so Earthlock is available from the 1st of September through to the 30th of September.
Okay.
Earthlock is new. It actually comes out on the 1st of September. And it is a turn-based role-playing game.
Sweet.
And it's not usually my kind of thing, but it does look quite good.
Yeah. Cool. Sounds like my kind of game. I'll give it a look.
Yeah.
Why not?
And that's an Xbox One game.
Sweet.
The other Xbox One game on offer from the 16th of September through to October 15th is Assassin's Creed Chronicles China.
Cool. Okay.
That is the side-scrolling, original Prince of Persia-esque Assassin's Creed game.
Sure.
Quite good fun. Worth playing.
Yeah, sure.
For 1,000 gamer score, anyway.
It's free, why not?
Yeah, it's free. Definitely go play it.
Yeah.
I think I mentioned this on last week's podcast, but I bought these on PS4 and they don't work.
Oh, yeah, you told me that,
so
yeah.
I'm going to get to play for free, I guess.
Yeah. Can't well. Yeah, kind of.
This is the one I'm excited about. Okay. Mainly because I didn't get to play it on 360. So, coming to backwards compatibility on the same day, and they're giving it to us for free, is the original Forza Horizon.
Nice.
If you had this game on 360, it was probably just about blowing your 360 up because it pushed it to its very limit.
Yeah.
Like Halo 4 was doing. So I had Halo 4 on Xbox 360, and I honestly thought my Xbox was just going to fall apart.
Yeah, it made very loud noises.
Really loud noises. So I'm excited for that because I haven't played it, and I love 2, and it's got incredible reviews. I was looking today, and it's just got amazing reviews.
Yeah, that's cool.
That one is available from September the 1st to September the 15th, so get that in the first half of September.
Cool.
And
the third one comes out soon as well.
Sorry?
Third one comes out soon, doesn't it?
Yeah, end of the month.
Yeah, cool.
And then the other Xbox 360 offering this month is the original Mirror's Edge.
Sweet.
Great game.
Yeah, it's
never finished it because the copy I had on PS3 froze. In the same place every time. I'd like jump off a wall and then I'd just freeze.
Weird. You have bad luck with games. Not working.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah, it's weird.
So I'm going to play through that as well, so that's cool.
Awesome.
Good selection. You got any gaming news?
Not really. Slow week.
It is.
What's happened? Gaming wise.
Week 4 of the WWE 2K17 roster reveal.
Sweet.
Another 30 superstars have been added to the roster.
Excellent.
Along with a Goldberg entrance video that we just watched.
We did.
It's been released.
It's pretty good.
Looks very cool. It's got the security guards knocking on Goldberg's door.
Yeah.
Weird thing is, it's on the WCW Nitro arena. So the entranceway is WCW Nitro. The nameplate when Goldberg appears is WCW Nitro. In the corner, where obviously it would say WCW if it was being shown on TV, is the mid-90s WWF logo cut down so it says WWE.
Yeah, weird. Weird choice.
Come on.
You own the rights to WCW and their logos. Why not just use it?
Yeah, you own that company.
Yeah, and then you have Lillian Garcia bloody announcing him.
Don't.
Yeah, doesn't even work with WWE anymore. I don't know.
No, she doesn't. She left for family reasons.
Oh,
her father's not very well.
All right. Okay.
So the 30 superstars that have been added this week. You ready?
Okay, I'm ready.
Have you seen them, or is this the first time you're going to hear them?
This will be my first time.
What a time to be alive for you!
I'm so excited. Hit me with it.
In alphabetical order.
Okay.
Alberto Del Rio.
Cool.
Big Cass.
Great.
Big Show.
Great.
Big Bray Wyatt.
Yeah, sure.
Brock Lesnar.
Of course.
Carmella.
Yeah.
Chad Gable.
Gable.
Darren Young.
Cool.
Dash Wilder of the Revival.
Sweet.
Dean Ambrose.
Awesome.
He's got an asterisk next to his name. I'm not sure why.
Hmm.
DDP. Earthquake.
Yo, it's me. It's me. Cool.
Enzo.
Of course.
Goldberg.
Of course.
Oh, how surprising. Why is that in there? How's that a roster reveal?
Yeah. The guy on the cover, you know.
You mean the guy on the original trailer?
Yeah.
Was he going to be in the game? I didn't even know. Fuck's sake.
Shocking.
Yeah. Jason Jordan.
Cool. Jordan. Okay. Jordan.
JBL.
Of course.
Great.
Jibble.
So we'll have JBL commentating and wrestling.
At the same time.
Mark Henry. Paige.
Cool.
Razor Ramon / Scott Hall.
Okay. Like we didn't know who he was, I guess.
I guess there's maybe two versions.
Maybe, yeah.
I hope they do that right, and the Razor Ramon character has the Razor Ramon music and entrance, and then Scott Hall has the NWO stuff.
That'd be cool, yeah. That'd be very cool.
Ric Flair.
Okay.
Rusev.
Masika.
Sami Zayn.
Cool.
Samoa Joe.
Cool.
Sasha Banks.
Yay.
Which I thought was revealed already.
Yeah, sure.
On that painting thing.
Yeah.
Scott Dawson of The Revival.
Yay.
Sheamus.
Cool.
The Miz.
Cool.
The Big Deal Titus O'Neil.
Cool.
Typhoon. And Zack Ryder.
Cool.
So there's 114 superstars announced so far.
Wow.
That's without DLC. So that's current superstars and WWE legends and women.
Excellent.
Or, as we like to refer to them as, Divas.
Nice.
We're getting good at that.
In sync, yeah.
Like, we've absolutely nailed it.
Yeah.
I'm so proud of this.
Good stuff.
Really good stuff. I'm never going to be half these wrestlers on here. I'm just looking at the list now.
Yeah. I can't wait to play as Typhoon.
But I probably will have Earthquake and Typhoon. Oh, yeah. I want the Legion of Doom.
Oh, yeah. That'd be cool.
I think Animal is currently suing WWE. So that probably isn't going to happen.
Yeah. Concussion thing, yeah.
Some sort of concussion. Like, everyone's come out of the woodwork for that now.
Yeah.
They didn't look after me when I banged my head as a professional wrestler.
Nobody told me hitting your head against things would hurt and cause damage to my brain. What do you think was going to happen?
Stupid.
Big guy.
Is he in it? He is, isn't he?
I think he is, yeah.
Of course he is. Oh, wait, hang on. I've got the full list here and I don't see him.
Oh, maybe he's not then. Maybe they took him out last minute.
Surely they're not that up to date, considering the Matadors are on it.
Yeah, and Stardust.
He'll be on next week's roster reveal.
You think so? Yeah, probably.
But he's not on there.
Weird.
Unless I can't... Rikishi, Rusev, Rick Rude, Ric Flair. No, he's not on there. Yeah. Good.
Yeah, great.
Yeah, sure. So, that's literally all the video game news. Like I said, not a lot, really. There's not much going on at the minute. It's just the calm before the storm of all the good games coming out.
Yeah, seriously.
And the PlayStation reveal, which is next month. But, you know, we like to keep you up to date with the little bits that go on in the world of video games.
Yeah.
So if you want yourself an Xbox onesie, go find one. Microsoft won't answer you back if you tweet them asking for one like we have.
Yeah. Maybe they get back to us eventually.
I hope so.
They better. And look, our friendship's off Xbox.
Yeah.
You're not friends anymore.
We want them jobs too.
Yeah.
We don't want much. We just want jobs and onesies.
Yeah, seriously.
We'll do our jobs in the onesies if that's what.
Yeah.
Have you got a onesie?
I don't, surprisingly.
What do you mean? Why surprisingly? Why is it surprisingly?
I don't know. Can you imagine me in a onesie?
I can imagine you in a Pikachu onesie.
Yeah. Well, if it was a Pikachu one, then yeah, I'd be all about it, yeah.
I have a Superman onesie.
Sweet. He's wearing the next time we do a stream.
Okay. I've got a Lucha Libre mask as well that I was going to wear for the next stream.
Except that and your Superman onesie.
Yeah.
Sweet.
The Super Lucha.
Nice.
And Lucha Man.
Lucha Man. Perfect.
Yeah.
We'll lose all our subscribers.
Why? But we're introducing a brand new character into our stream.
That's true, yeah. That's, sorry, Sonny couldn't be here today, but we do have a special guest, Lucha Man.
Yay.
Yeah. Everyone's like, what is this?
Yeah.
Like, I've tolerated these guys for long enough because I like watching WWE 2K16. But this is going too far.
Too much.
This is too much.
No, people love it.
People will absolutely. They'll mark out.
They will, absolutely.
Yeah. Then the next stream, they'll be like, where's Lucha Man?
Yeah, really.
Bring back Lucha Man because Sonny sucks.
Yeah.
Just give us Lucha Man instead.
Yeah. Bring us Sonny versus Lucha Man for the title.
I think Lucha Man would win.
Yeah.
He has more presence.
Yeah, true.
Yeah, I'm just Sonny.
A sweet mask.
It is a sweet mask.
It is a sweet mask.
Yeah. You've not seen it, have you?
I've not.
Okay. We're just assuming that it is because Lucha Man, obviously, you're now sold on Lucha Man as a character.
I mean, all Lucha Man's are pretty cool. Don't they?
Yes, I agree. Yes, you know, I'm with you on that. Right, so let's move on to wrestling. let's first talk about NXT TakeOver Brooklyn 2.
Okie dokie.
How did you enjoy the show?
I did.
Yeah?
It's great. Put the highlight of the weekend for me. Probably better all overall than SummerSlam, in my opinion.
It was a lot shorter. I mean, it was only 2.5 hours. It was only advertised originally to be 2. So, it was a very good event. I thought there was two. Oh, I didn't realize it was a pre-show.
Oh, there was.
Yeah.
Any matches on it, or just talking?
Ty Dillinger beat Wesley Blake.
Oh,
and the Authors of Pain beat TM61.
Oh, no way.
Jose.
Oh, yeah. I see what you did there.
You see? But the show itself was excellent, I thought.
Oh, yeah.
Really enjoyed enjoyed it from start to finish. Like, Austin Aries beat No Way Jose. Good match.
Yep.
Loved the crowd singing No Way Jose's entrance.
Yeah. Like the conga line going at the start.
Yeah.
Members on the crowd.
Huge pop for Austin Aries.
Yes.
So the crowd are taken to him, because I think at the start that's just somebody pulling their bin around. We've got the window open because it is hot.
If there is
a little bit of background noise, then it's just somebody pulling the bin around. Yeah, so it looks like finally the crowd have accepted Austin Aries. I think they were a little bit unsure when he first joined, but the crowd really popped for him. And I'm happy.
Yeah,
I'm happy that he won.
That's awesome.
Who do we have? We've got the predictions.
Oh yeah, of course we do, yeah. So NXT predictions. So you said Aries would win. I said Jose would win. And you were right, so you get a point.
Ding.
Ding.
Ember Moon debuted.
Yes.
And had a very impressive debut.
Very impressive.
Talking
about the NXT match with Austin Aries and No Way Jose, after the match, Hideo Itami came down.
Yes.
And attacked, because Aries continued to attack No Way Jose after the match. And Hideo Itami came down to make the save, and he hit him with a GTS.
Yeah,
finally.
That was big, actually, because, I mean, I've not been impressed with Hideo since he came back. I said this to you the other day. I've not been into it. I wasn't feeling it as much as I was when, you know, he first came in and it was like, it was awesome and did all this cool stuff. He's come back. He's not had the momentum that he had when he left, and the crowd seemed to forget him a little. Mm. But he came back at TakeOver and the crowd was super into it. He wasn't wearing socks with his suit.
Yeah.
but he hit a GTS. And everyone marked out.
Yeah, that was really cool.
I'm so surprised the crowd didn't start chanting CM Punk. Surprised.
Yeah. There were CM Punk chants at SummerSlam, but then the crowd was kind of a dick.
There it is.
So,
Ember Moon made her debut.
Yep.
Were you impressed with Ember Moon?
Very impressed, yeah. It was cool. I love her look. I love her red eyes. It's very cool. Most importantly, I love her finisher. They're twisting top rope stunner. So cool.
So cool. I couldn't believe it. Like, when I saw it, I was like, holy shit.
Yeah.
Like, there's so much room to get that wrong.
Yeah, seriously. But no, so impressive. I'd say that Billy Kay looked good as well. I like Billy Kay's entrance into the new music.
Yeah, and we even said on the stream last week,
yeah,
the NXT TakeOver stream, that we thought Billy Kay had terrible music.
Yeah.
Then she turns up at TakeOver with brand new music. So we're the real winners there.
Yeah, seriously. It's looked great. It's got an awesome looking cape. Behind her.
I've been really impressed with Billy Kay anyway.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, I knew that the women's division in NXT needed a little bit of a resurgence since the main girls left.
Yeah, yeah. She's
not but I think Billy Kay is, you know, she's good. I think the crowd will hate her because she portrays that sort of character.
Yeah, yeah.
But I like her. And she put on a good show, and I'm happy with that.
Yeah, me too. Yeah,
great finish from Ember Moon. It's so like a twisting stunner from the top rope, and it's... If you haven't seen it, it's honestly awesome. There's a gif of it somewhere, I'm certain.
Oh, for sure. Super cool.
Bobby Roode,
mm-hmm,
who had an excellent entrance, and as I predicted, the crowd were singing Glorious.
Of course.
And it was awesome. He beat Andrade Cien Almas,
mm-hmm,
in a good match. I enjoyed it. I thought, I don't think Cien did anything to disgrace himself.
No, he looked good. I do think they need to put him up against someone who the crowd don't actually like, because so far he's fought. Who did he go against first? Austin Aries.
Yeah, possibly.
Yeah, because the crowd's always going to cheer for like Aries or Bobby Roode.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
I like him a lot. I'm really impressed with him. No, he fought Ty Dillinger first.
Dillinger, that was it. Who people love, of course.
Yeah. I really like him, but he's not got off to the best of starts. I don't know where he goes from here, but, you know, NXT does so well at taking the guys who aren't doing so well, then pushing them straight into the spotlight, and all of a sudden they're doing well.
Yeah,
look at Ty Dillinger.
Yeah, yeah.
CN, he will do well. Obviously, Bobby Roode won this match, which I'm sure we both had.
Yeah, yeah.
Had Ember Moon as well, obviously.
Yeah, of course. Had a cool entrance as well when he came down from like a lift thing.
Yeah, like a crane, wasn't it?
Yeah, pretty much.
But it was cool, really, really good. Cool to see Bobby Roode. He fits right in.
Yeah, for sure. Do you think I wasn't overly fond of was Roode's finisher? It's like a pump handle slam.
That is literally all it was a pump handle slam. Like that was Road Dogg's finishing move all them years ago.
Yeah, exactly.
Look, Paul Heyman said you can take a headlock, and as long as you make it believable and you're finishing people with it every week, they will start to appreciate it.
That's true.
If we know that that's his finish going forward, I'm fine with it. It just looks a little weak to me.
Yeah, same. He's expecting something a bit more glorious, but that's fine.
Very nice.
Thank you.
Yeah. In what was quite easily match of the night.
Yes.
The Revival beat my guys, Scott Dawson. Nope, that's wrong.
Wrong one.
Wrong. Johnny Gargano and Tommaso Ciampa.
That's the one.
Who are now called DIY.
Yeah.
Because nobody will do it for you.
Exactly. It works.
Fine. I like the t-shirt. It's very basic, very simple. Yep. That's cool. I want one.
That's like DIY.
Yes. Such a good match. We knew this was going to be good anyway.
Oh, yeah.
But it was. It just... I mean, the build-up has been great. Gargano and Ciampa have been awesome as the good guys and the underdogs. The Revival have been doing their best work, promoting themselves as top guys, as they say.
Mm-hmm.
And they've been really solid, and I've enjoyed the build-up, and the match was excellent, told a great story. I want it to carry on, and I want them to go again at the next TakeOver. And I'm sure they will. And I have no doubt that Gargano and Ciampa will win those championships. But excellent match. Easily the match of the night.
Yeah, seriously. There's so many like awesome false finishes when you think, oh, they're going to win or they're going to lose. And it kicked out the last second. And oh, it was so good.
Like, even when I thought it was going to finish, it didn't finish. And I was like, oh my God, I just cannot believe how good this is.
So good.
But the Revival won.
Yeah.
Which you called. I had my guys to win it.
So I was scrolling down the page here. Right at the bottom. Yeah, you're right.
So that's a point to you.
Point to me. Point to each.
So I think we pretty much had this quite close anyway, didn't we?
Yeah, pretty much. We all pretty much said the same thing, apart from, Aries and Jose in this one.
Yeah. Oscar and Bayley had a better match than I thought they would.
Yeah, it was really good.
Oscar looks great.
Yep.
Obviously, this was Bayley's swan song. Bayley lost, of course. Which we both predicted.
Yeah,
and then she said goodbye to the NXT universe in a fitting way, I think.
Yeah.
They said thank you. They were chanting thank you, Bayley, and it was a really emotional moment. It was cool. It was nice. But the match itself was great. That's all I can really say about it. It was great.
Yeah. Asuka kicked out of the Bayley to belly. And then Bayley got out of the multiple like Asuka locks. So both looked good, strong coming out of it. Asuka ended up winning with a flurry of kicks. Last one to the back of her head, knocking him out.
Yeah, like a buzzsaw kick, like Tajiri-esque.
Yeah, exactly, yeah. It looked cool. And, I look forward to seeing what Asuka can do in the future.
Yeah, I think she's looking phenomenal at the minute as well, Asuka. Mm. Like, physically and sort of in the ring.
Yeah, yeah.
Like, she's trimmed down a lot because she... and I mean this with all respect to Asuka. When she came in, she wasn't in WWE superstar shape.
Sure.
You understand what I mean by that?
But neither is Samoa Joe.
No, but even Joe's trimmed down. But Joe, we knew what we were getting sort of going in. Joe's a big guy.
Yeah.
WWE has a typical view of what women look like or are supposed to look like. I don't know. That's a stupid thing that WWE has sort of been like all this time.
Yeah.
Starting to change a bit because obviously now we've got Nia.
Yep.
And, Oscar is a different sort of athlete. But she's just to go back to what I said, I mean, Oscar's looking great at the minute.
She is.
She's trimmed down. She looks great. She's gorgeous. Great.
Asuka's awesome. I love her.
Yeah, she's great. Nakamura versus Samoa Joe for the NXT Championship. How did you feel about the match, and how did you feel about the finish?
It's a very good match. Entrance for Nakamura was awesome with the violin, live violin.
Cool. Like, it was literally goosebumps.
Yeah, seriously. Yeah, amazing match. Again, both kicking out of each other's finisher. Easy for me to say. And something neither of us called, but Nakamura actually ended up winning. Amazing.
Very surprised.
Out of multiple Kinshasa knees to the face, one of which might have actually broken his jaw, from the looks of things.
Yeah, there is an update for Joe, but I haven't read it. I'm assuming he is injured.
It looked like it. The referee threw up the X, which is normally a bad sign. But yeah, other than that, amazing match. I loved it. How about you?
Yeah, I mean, I liked it. It was very slow. It was very slow to start with. I mean, you know that I'm a big fan of different styles. So this doesn't bother me. For casual fans, they probably wouldn't have enjoyed it so much, but NXT isn't really for the casuals.
That's true.
But no, I thought it was great. So I have to be honest, I didn't want Nakamura to win.
Really?
I wanted Joe to win.
You're a big Smojo fan.
I'm a big Joe guy. I really am.
That's fair.
You know, I'm happy for Nakamura to win it eventually, but Joe hasn't had it long enough.
You might win it back. You don't know. I think there's a good chance he's going to win it back and become a two-time champion. And then Nakamura will, I don't know, maybe win it back eventually.
I don't think that's going to happen. I think Joe's main roster bound.
Okay. I'm fine with that.
I have a theory, and I'll share it in a short while because it fits into something else that we have to talk about wrestling-wise. But, I enjoyed the match. It wasn't the best match on the card, and it wasn't as good as I wanted it to be, I think.
Okay.
But either way, good match. I'm happy for Nakamura. Obviously, he's going to be amazing, and he is the biggest superstar that NXT has.
Yeah.
Just feel like Joe could have been given a little longer.
Yeah, that's fair.
Unless, of course, that, you know, there's bigger and better things on the horizon for Joe, then I'm fine.
Yeah.
But overall, I thought it was good. Out of 10, what'd you give it?
Out of 10, I'll give it a solid 8. 8.5, maybe.
8, that's fair. I'm going to go with 8 as well.
Okay.
Yeah.
Not the greatest match ever, but still extremely good. I liked it a lot.
What are you giving 8 out of 10 here? The whole show or the match?
The match. The whole show would give probably... Yeah, probably an 8 as well, to be fair.
Yeah, I was... Yeah, 8 for me.
Yeah.
Yeah, it was good. Enjoyed it. I was so excited for it. I mean, these things never live up to your excitement.
No. But, yeah. No, I'm not saying it was bad.
Oh, no. It wasn't at all.
No.
And I just want to clear it up. I wasn't having a go at Oscar either in the shape that she was in when she came to WWE. But I imagine that they told her to trim down a little.
Yeah, that's fair. I was looking up injury update to Joe.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
All right, so let's move on to SummerSlam.
Okie dokie.
This was an interesting event for me. I wasn't overly hyped going into SummerSlam.
Yeah.
Simply because I don't think the build-up has been very good. Since that first episode of Raw, where after the brand split... I just don't think it's been very good. I don't think the main roster stuff has been good at all.
Yeah, that's fair.
Like, I've been relying on NXT and the CWC to pick my wrestling expectations back up off the floor after Raw and SmackDown have just, like, stood on them. You know?
Yeah.
So I wasn't hyped going in at all.
Okay.
By the way, if you watched all of the wrestling this weekend...
That's a lot of wrestling.
2.5 hours of NXT, not including the pre-show. So, 3.5 hours of NXT with a pre-show. 6 hours of SummerSlam with that pre-show. So that's 2 hours of pre-show and 4 hours of SummerSlam. 3 hours of Raw and 2 hours of SmackDown. You deserve a fucking medal because that is a lot of wrestling to take in.
Yeah.
I mean, I didn't do the pre-show for either NXT or SummerSlam. And I feel like I've watched a lot of wrestling this weekend.
Yeah, seriously. Literally, like, counting, like, superstars and main event and all those other...
Yeah.
Like, Holy Foley and all sort of crap.
What do you think, Holy Foley?
Haven't seen it.
Oh, okay.
Don't care.
We've been watching it. it's fun.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, it's a lot of fun.
Yeah, I was a big fan of, like, reality TV, stuff like that.
That's fair enough.
Yeah.
It's not... it isn't to everyone's taste.
No, that's fair, yeah.
But I like it. It's fun. But cool. I like Total Divas. Divas. I said to you before the podcast that it probably isn't worth us running down the card, but for prediction's sake, we're going to have to.
Oh, yeah.
How did NXT finish up, prediction-wise?
With a tie, believe it or not.
Oh, really?
We both pretty much had the same results most of the way through.
Oh, and we both had Joe to win, didn't we?
Yeah. So, tie? Yeah. One tie. One point each.
Huh?
Yeah, give us 1 point each.
Okay, basically. 1 point each. That's good. Right. This could be very different.
It could be.
Did we do the pre-show matches?
Some of them. A couple of them. Because most of them weren't announced yet when we did a podcast.
Okay. American Alpha, Jason Jordan, Chad Gable, of course.
Yep.
The Hype Bros and the Usos defeated the heel team of Breezango, the Ascension, the Vaudevillains.
They sure did.
Great.
Next.
In the SmackDown Tag Team Showcase.
Yeah.
Whatever. It lasted 14 minutes, surprisingly.
Yeah. I skipped through it. It was fine, I guess.
Sami Zayn and Neville beat the Dudley Boys.
Why was it on the pre-show?
Yeah, I know. Why was it on the pre-show?
Yeah.
To be honest, we obviously thought that it was to split the to start the wheels in motion of the Dudley splitting up.
Yeah, yeah.
And I think the entire internet thought that.
Yeah, I mean, Bubba did hit Devon during the match by accident. So it looked like that was going to happen, but nope. Just lost and wandered off.
Great.
Yeah.
It's such a pointless match.
It was, yeah. So
Sammy and Neville both deserve better, especially if the Dudleys are gone now. Sammy and Neville deserve much better.
Yep.
We must have done a prediction for this one because it's a big one.
Yep.
Sheamus beat Cesaro.
Yep.
In the first match of the series.
Yes. We both picked Sheamus to win this, and we were both right.
We both think that Cesaro is going to end up being the eventual winner of this series.
For sure, yeah.
But it makes sense for Sheamus to win the first one simply because it makes Sheamus look strong for the rest of the series. It sets him up.
Yeah, and it also gives Cesaro to chase, the comeback.
I think Sheamus will go 2 or 3 up.
Yeah, he probably won't, yeah. I wouldn't be surprised.
Yeah. I don't think there's anybody who watches wrestling who thinks that Sheamus is going to win that series.
Yeah, probably not. They might throw a curveball in there and just have him win just to screw with us. I don't know.
Maybe.
He shouldn't win though, I don't think.
A little bit disappointing this on the pre-show.
Yeah, it's a good match.
I did take the time out of my life to see this one. I didn't watch the other two.
Same.
But
it was very cool. At one point, it's always a very cool looking springboard from the ring post onto the ropes into I think it was the spinning
European uppercut.
Yeah, I think so. It was very cool looking.
Yeah.
I have to write in my notes.
Cesaro is an outstanding athlete. Sheamus is misused, is the word that I would use to describe Sheamus.
Yeah, Sheamus is good. I like Sheamus.
Yeah, I like Sheamus too. He's just misused.
Yeah, I think when he came back with a mohawk and all that, he should have come back like a monster heel. But instead, he just came back the same as he always was, just laughing idiot. Irish man.
Well, that's the thing. They're just poorly booked. So when Del Rio came back and then they just stuck these guys in one faction. And, you know, when you get factions, there's always people who get lost in the shuffle and it's rubbish. And unfortunately, that's what happened to Sheamus. And then he went off to film the Turtles movie. And, you know, it just, there's so many things that Sheamus, he could do with winning this series. I have to be honest, he could.
Yeah.
Because it would reinvigorate Sheamus. And I think it would make people believing in him more.
Yeah, that's true. But then Cesaro kind of gets screwed. I don't know.
Cesaro should have been drafted to SmackDown.
Yeah, I agree.
He suits the SmackDown, sort of style more, I think.
Yeah.
Where Sheamus is a very typical Vince McMahon WWE wrestler.
That's true.
Oh. Yeah. Chris Jericho and Kevin Owens defeated Enzo Amore and Big Cass.
Good.
Superb opening promo from Enzo again. We say this every single time, but the guy is excellent.
He's very good at the mic, yeah.
So good.
No, I do think it's getting a bit stale now. It's kind of the same thing every week. You know, how are you doing? And all that. Yeah, I don't know.
Finn.
I don't know. He just needs to, find some new material, I guess. For me, anyway. I don't know. Crowd seems to love him still.
I love it. Do love it. That's fine. And I think he's very clever.
I do like him. He's very funny and all that. He's just, I don't know.
He's doing what he knows works.
Well, that's true, yeah.
Jesus. The New Age Outlaws used that same shtick for years.
That's true, yeah.
And then when they came back, when they were, obviously older and somehow had another championship run, were still using the same thing.
Yeah, that's true.
I've got a lot of time for the New Age Outlaws. I could come back now and I'd steal all of it. but yeah, I think we both said that Jericho and Kevin Owens would win.
Where was it? Oh, it's in there somewhere. So many matches get lost in the
show. Yeah, I know. SummerSlam had a huge card.
Yeah.
It was like, it was crazy.
Yeah, we did both have Jericho to win.
I think our predictions were fairly similar for this as well, you know. Actually, I'm not sure. I can't remember.
Oh, yeah, pretty much. I had a few here and there.
Charlotte won the Women's Championship.
Yes.
Thoughts? Obviously, we know there's a reason behind it. And yeah. For that, it's fine and I will let it go.
Yeah. Yeah, shocking. I literally threw up my arms in shock when Charlotte got the pin. Mm-hmm. I think it was the bank statement, and she kind of rolled her up onto her back and got the three count. I was like, what?
I shook my head. Yeah. I knew this was going to happen because I was talking with Steve.
Oh, yeah.
Because he mentioned in the stream that one of the odds for the championship matches had significantly changed.
Yeah.
And I asked him which one it was, and obviously he told me.
It was that one.
So I sort of knew it was coming. Sasha Banks is injured, or... Yeah. Not so much injured, but she's got niggling injuries that she needs to recover from.
Yeah.
And I'm fine with that.
Because
there is no point in ruining your body when you could just heal up and come back stronger. Yeah. She's very young.
Yeah, for sure.
So time is on Sasha's... I can find it so hard to say her name.
Sasha. Relax. Yeah.
Your time is on her side.
For sure. Not surprised she did. She keeps lying on her goddamn head all the time. on her face.
She took a nasty-looking bump on the turnbuckle as well.
Yeah, I don't know what the hell that was supposed to be.
Charlotte just dropped it. It looked like she did it... I don't know if she did it wrong or whether it was a fluff or what. I don't know.
Yeah, she kind of went up on the second rope and just kind of dropped her.
Yeah, literally dropped her as well. It's like it wasn't even... It wasn't even subtle. She just dropped her.
Yeah, just like legs hit the ropes and then her head went flopping down onto the mat. It's like, ooh, yeah. Nasty. Luckily, she was okay.
Yeah, so Sasha's taking a bit of time off and that's why Charlotte... ended up winning the belt. Sasha will win it again before the end of the year, I have no doubt.
Yeah, for sure.
Charlotte is a monster heel, and she plays the role so well. Mm-hmm. I have no problem.
Yep, that's totally fine.
With them.
Probably one of the top heels in the company right now, because people actually boo her.
Yeah, but she's so dislikable.
Exactly, yeah.
Like she just plays that heel character like incredibly well. She knows how to work the crowd. Having Ric Flair as your dad and your mentor, without question, helps, because he knew.
For sure, yeah. Yeah, she's very good. I like her a lot.
She's very, very good. The Miz versus Apollo Crews.
Mm-hmm.
The Miz retained.
He did.
But The Miz is on a roll at the minute. I wanted Apollo to win.
You did. In fact, you said that in your predictions.
I had Apollo to win. Certainly, we both lost a point for Sasha there.
Oh, we did, yeah. We both did. Sasha. The whole internet said Sasha.
Yeah. if you'd have had Charlotte at the bookies before...
The
odds changed. You might have done well there.
Yeah, yeah.
I'll confirm this with Steve. See what he says.
Sweet.
But The Miz won. He retained his championship.
Yep.
I don't know what the deal with Apollo is. He's lost at the minute. He's really lost. He's too good for too mainstream for NXT. Too boring for the main roster. I don't want to say boring because he's a likable guy. I really, really like him. I want him to do well.
Yeah, he's a very impressive wrestler. And all the like crazy flippy stuff, despite being a massive, huge, tough guy.
Yeah.
He just doesn't have the charisma, I think. He's missing something, the it's factor, I guess. From
$1 million smile, $4 promo skills.
Yeah, pretty much.
I really like him, and I don't know what they do with him now. What do they do? You tell me. What do they do with him?
Send him to acting school? I don't know. It's weird. But yeah, I like him. He's a great guy and everything.
It even showed on Breaking Ground, didn't it? Like he was struggling with the promo side of things because he just comes across as too stiff.
I think he'll get better. Maybe if they turn him heel, he'll be able to do something with that. We'll see.
Maybe. That it's difficult. The Miz is on a hot streak at the minute. We'll go into that more in a little while. But he's making the best of his IC championship run. You think he's going to lose it, and he doesn't lose it, and he keeps getting stronger. We say it all the time, we like The Miz on this show.
Yeah.
We are Miz fans.
Yeah.
The Miz is horrifically underrated.
Yeah. Seriously.
People don't like him because he came from a reality TV background, and, you know, he's not your typical wrestler. He hasn't done time on the indies and all that sort of crap.
Yeah.
He came into WWE, did tough enough.
Yeah, started tough enough.
Yeah, and now he is where he is. He was the world champion, for Christ's sake.
Yeah.
And at that point, WWE was very popular.
Yeah, well...
And he was everywhere.
His world championship run wasn't great, in my opinion. just because I think the other people who might deserve it a bit better, CM Punk.
But they had the balls to put it on him.
Yeah, they, yeah.
Forget CM Punk. Fuck him. Right. I'm not interested in CM Punk. All of his. Oh, he should have had this. That's gone out the window now.
Yeah, I don't know. At the time, it seemed like he should have.
Yeah, fine, whatever. At the time, fine. But now, all of that's gone out the window. The Miz is better. Fuck CM Punk.
Okay. Yeah, moving swiftly on. But yeah, Maurice looked really good, by the way, also.
Sure he does.
Yes.
Sure he does. He's awesome.
Lucky Miz. God damn it.
Match of the night next.
Yes, 100%. Possibly a match of the year. Another contender for sure. For me, at least.
Absolute contender, yeah. Top five. There's been so many.
Yeah, so many good matches.
The Cruiserweight Classic is literally blown this category wide open.
Yeah.
We'll do when it comes to the end of the year and we do our last podcast of the year, we'll talk about we'll have our matches of the year.
Yeah.
And it's gonna be very difficult. We're gonna have to do like a top 10.
Yeah, for sure.
This was superb. Cena always has good matches. He's always given the platform to have good matches. This was the longest match on the card, I think.
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah, this went, according to Wikipedia, it went 23 minutes and 10 seconds. That's the longest match by about 5 minutes.
Cool.
But it was good. AJ Styles is outstanding and just knows he's fit right into WWE AJ Styles. He's had no problem at all. He's been a champion wherever he goes. And I think there's a championship run in his near future.
For sure. Especially after this.
But this was I don't want to, I didn't need to sort of use the pun, but it was phenomenal. Yeah. Really enjoyed it.
It was so good. Eddie kicked out of so many AAs, even the like top rope AA he kicked out, which I thought was going to be the end. It's like, oh, Lord Cena wins.
Yeah.
And he got the stroller up. So good. He had Star Slash followed by a phenomenal forearm and got the three.
Yeah, I mean, it was just great through the match. I mean, you had the STFs and you had the calf killer and, you know, AJ flying all over the place with the 450 springboard.
Yeah,
and
I loved Cena's expression after, like, AJ kicked out of
the top rope AA, wasn't it? Yeah.
He was like, wow, what do I have to do?
At that point, I knew AJ was going to win.
Yeah, I think so. Me too.
But it was great. It was a great way to end the feud as well.
Very good.
Interesting after the match.
Yes. Oh, before that, the only thing I didn't like, which I've want to say for a while, they need to switch the effectiveness of the Star Slash on the forearm. Because the Star Slash is like this big, like, devastating looking, awesome looking move.
Mm-hmm.
And the forearm is just the forearm.
Agreed. Because the Star Slash, he turns it into a pin.
Yeah.
So don't, because he leaves the Star Slash, then goes for the forearm. The forearm should be the setup, I agree.
Yeah. Because, like, I don't know. It's a forearm. It's like a nothing move.
It's awesome because he gets a lot of velocity behind it, and that's something that AJ Styles has always managed to do really well.
Yeah, true.
He's managed to get a lot of... he makes the forearm look like a powerful forearm, because even with the springboard, he makes it look excellent.
Mm.
But I do think the Styles Clash should be the finish.
Yeah, for sure. Because the last Styles Clash of the match, Cena just like stood straight back up. It's like, oh, God, come on.
I know, but it was a great match. Good to see AJ Styles win it.
Oh, yeah. I don't know, it's phenomenal, yeah. Damn it.
We keep doing it.
Can't stop myself.
We just love it. We just can't help it.
You can't help it.
But I think we both had AJ to win.
Yep.
It was really brilliant. If you haven't seen it, and if you listen to this podcast, you probably have.
Yeah.
You should go and watch it. Or if you've got friends that don't watch wrestling, show them these matches. Show them the list that we're going to give you at the end of the year.
Yeah, seriously.
Make them sit down and watch the best matches of 2016, because there has been some really good ones.
Really, really good.
Cena left his never give up armband in the ring at the end of the match, and it looked like a farewell, sort of like Bayley when she left NXT just the night before.
Yeah, yeah.
What do you make of it? What do you think?
I don't know. I don't know.
There's no way Cena's done.
No way. He'll be back next. He'll be back soon. He was on SmackDown this week, but he'll be back, I'm sure.
I think he's going to take a bit of time off.
Yeah, that makes sense. So it's very similar to when The Undertaker like took off his gloves and left him in the ring after whatever WrestleMania that was.
Yep.
So I don't know. It could be symbolizing something else happening in the future. Like maybe a heel turn.
That's dead in the water.
Yeah,
that's never happening now.
Yeah, I think you're probably right.
I thought it was going to happen at SummerSlam. Then I thought it was going to happen before SummerSlam when the six-man tag happened.
Yeah.
Didn't happen, it's done. Never going to happen again.
Yeah, for a second when, like, after the Super AA and seeing that look in his face, I thought maybe that could be the start of the heel turn, but no, it didn't. Never happened.
I think Cena will have a bit of time off, then come back.
Yeah, you probably won't.
And he'll have a championship run.
Yeah,
I'm calling it.
Yes. Yeah.
He's going to hold that SmackDown title.
Yeah, for sure.
Yep. I don't think he's had that version of the WWE Championship, has he?
No, I don't think so.
I don't think he has.
No.
Because Rollins had it. Who had it after that? Reigns?
Yeah. It
was Brock?
Rollins, Reigns, Brock, Seth. Again.
Ambrose.
And yeah, that's it.
See, Casino had the US title for ages.
Yeah, he did.
Okay. He'll be gone for a while, but he'll be back.
Yep.
Didn't like this next one.
Oh, John Stewart, yeah.
I like John Stewart. Yeah. Just stop being in WWE.
Yeah, why are you here?
Like, turn up, do comedy segment, fine. Don't interrupt the matches, because it's...
The crowd did not like John Stewart.
So, this is for the Tag Team Championships. I do think it's time the New Day dropped the belts, and I think that was the perfect time for them to drop the belts.
Agreed.
This feud is clearly going to carry on because of, you know, they did carry on Raw.
Yeah.
But, they beat Gallows and Anderson. Oh, no, they didn't. Gallows and Anderson won by DQ because of Jon Stewart.
That's right.
And Big E.
Which means we both get a point. Because we both said the club would win.
That is cheap. What a cheap way for us to get points.
Yeah,
it's... That was disappointing for me.
Yeah,
I was really disappointed by it. I don't think celebrities should be used to interrupt championship matches.
Agreed. It's stupid what last
Big
year.
I don't give a shit if Jon Stewart's nut gets crashed.
Yeah.
Crushed.
But, yeah. They did the same last year with him interrupting Cena and Seth.
Was that SummerSlam?
I think so. Yeah, they mentioned it on the thing, yeah. Please don't make this a yearly thing. Let this be the end of it now.
Yeah, we don't want this to be a Pete Rose at WrestleMania type thing where Pete Rose turned up at WrestleMania, took a tombstone from Kane and, you know, happened for a couple of few years in a row. Wrestling fans don't want to see it. It's very old-fashioned.
Yep. That'll be the end of it now. It's had its fun. Now it's thing you can stop.
Yep. Dean Ambrose beat Dolph Ziggler to retain the WWE Championship.
Shocking.
For SmackDown.
Yes.
Unsurprising.
Dean seemed a bit different in this match. I don't know about you.
It looks like he's... I'm not sure if they're turning him or not.
Yeah, he was definitely wrestling as a heel. I don't know if that was just because Dolph is the default babyface. I don't know. It's weird.
It is weird. And I thought it was an okay match. I don't think...
It's fine.
I mean, they were given 15 minutes plus.
Yeah.
And they did what they could in that 15 minutes. I thought it was fine. We knew Ambrose was going to win, so it wasn't a big shock. Really, at the end of it. But
it was a standard Dolph Ziggler match, I thought. It was a good match. It wasn't the best match of the night. It did its job fine.
And now it would appear that Dolph Ziggler is in free fall.
Yeah.
So Dolph Ziggler's had his chance, and now he's sort of going to drop off a bit.
Yeah. Also, where was Bray Wyatt in this? He spent all these last few weeks like interfering with Dean's matches and like attacking Dolph Ziggler and all that. And it's like, he wasn't there. Nothing happened.
Yeah, and then what happened on SmackDown this week made no sense at all.
Yeah.
So, I don't know. We will come to that. But, yeah, I agree. Very, very easy to call match. And strange that Bray wasn't involved.
Yeah.
Natalia, Alexa Bliss, and a mystery partner.
And yeah, Eva Marie. Ooh.
Took on Becky Lynch, Naomi, and Carmella. Now, what I liked here is the Eva Marie part. It really made me laugh.
Yeah, that's so cool.
I mean, you said that this could happen.
Yeah.
And in fact, you called it.
Yeah.
I said they wouldn't do it because WWE acknowledged the suspension and people just don't buy bullshit anymore. But they did it in a way where it was very funny.
Yeah.
Like, she was off with anxiety because of
a toxic crowd.
Something like that. And it was really good. And they've done it really well. And they're still building Eva Marie's heel character while she isn't there.
Yeah.
If Eva Marie can brush up on her wrestling skills, she's going to be the top fucking heel on SmackDown.
Yeah, seriously.
Because they don't like her anyway.
Mm-hmm.
But if she actually learned to wrestle properly.
Yeah.
If she's spending this time now while she's away perfecting her craft, she could come back and be outstanding.
Yeah, agreed. She could be the best thing that happened to the women's division in a long time. if she can actually wrestle.
Yeah, we're speaking in ifs here. We're not saying that Eve Marie is going to revolutionize women's wrestling.
No.
Or anything like that. We're just saying that she could be the heel diva woman that SmackDown needs.
Yeah.
In that division.
Agreed.
The mystery tag team partner, much to my surprise, I have to be honest, it was Nikki Bella.
Yeah.
Great to see her back.
Yeah, I mean, my notes, Sonny will be pleased.
I was really, really pleased.
You can look, but you can't touch. Something, yes. Something, stars above.
We sung the song on the stream at SummerSlam.
Yeah.
You can go back and hear us do that. What a time to be alive that was.
Yeah, she got a really huge pop, supposedly. So especially considering she was on the bad guy team.
Yeah, weird time to bring her back, but I think they had no other options.
Yeah, I think you're right. No one else was there. So yeah, it's fine. I'm okay with Team Nikki.
Yeah, I'm happy. Nikki's team had to win.
Yep.
You can't bring her back for her to lose.
Yes,
she's too big a star for that.
Yeah.
This is hurting. I don't know if this SmackDown Women's Division at the minute is hurting Becky, because the Women's Division isn't really doing anything.
Yeah.
Until now, because going forward, of course, they're going to be fighting for a brand new Women's Championship, which we'll talk about in a little while.
Yep.
But all this women's stuff at the minute is just building the characters up.
Yeah, I agree.
But yeah, great to see Nikki back. Okay match, I guess.
You should have a new finisher. It's like a TKO. Before it was the rack attack, which I think is what injured her in the first place.
I think that's doing more damage to her than good. So I think she had to change it. I think we watched Total Divas. And I think sort of touches on that on Total Divas. The rack attack is not a safe move to do, really, because it's putting more pressure on her back. So things like that, you've got to change. You have to change your style up to suit your body.
Yeah.
I mean, you can't take risks. That's why Sasha Banks is taking time off, because you just can't take risks.
Yeah. Stop landing on your face, Sasha. Damn it.
Yeah. Stop just completely face planting. Diving out of the ring like a crazy person.
Yeah. But I thought Nick looked good. I liked the new finisher. And yeah. The shame the crowd kind of died halfway through the match, but whatever. the crowd did.
Speaking of crowd. Mm-hmm.
But yeah.
Next match was Finn Balor versus Seth Rollins for the brand new WWE Universal Championship.
And what a belt it is.
I honestly don't mind it. I wish, like I said to you before we started recording, I wish the strap was black and the plate was red, like the Women's Championship, but for the men.
Yeah, instead of the white strap, black strap. Yeah, I agree. That'd be better.
Yeah, but like the whole thing's red.
Yeah,
The plate, the strap.
I think people were expecting like a brand new looking belt, which I was expecting too. Like a 7, it's like a completely redesigned, cool looking new belt. It's first new major championship belt in a long time, and we just got red WWE belt.
But when you think about it logically,
yeah,
what did you actually want it to look like?
I don't know, something cool. Not that. I don't know. For me, it's the colours.
They obviously want consistency with the titles.
That's fine. Yeah, but I mean, the colours just clash. It was designed by the bloody belt creator in 2K16. So, like, come on, you can do better than that.
But at least when we do our streams while we're still playing 2K16, we can have the accurate belts.
That's true, yeah.
Really good match. Under 20 minutes.
Yeah, great match.
The crowd pissed me off during it, because they were too busy chanting for the belt. Seth Rollins was pissed off at this as well, because he tweeted out that Brooklyn let him down, because it isn't about what the belt looks like, it's about what it stands for.
Yeah, I agree.
I'm with him. I didn't like that the crowd just went into a bit. Hey, look, if you're going to pay to go to see wrestling, you can have you can do whatever you want.
Oh, yeah, for sure.
But at least have the decency to watch and respect the match.
Yeah.
Because that's what you're there for. You're not there to sit and chant at a fucking belt that can't chant back at you.
Yeah, that's dumb. The thing I find funny was, like, every time the belt was on the screen, it's booed. It was always quite funny. But yeah, they went too far with the chanting and all that crap.
Yeah, it's just nonsense. It's like when the crowd start chanting JBL and Michael Cole the day after WrestleMania and all this sort of stuff. It's like, look, you've done it once. It was funny the first time. It isn't funny now.
No, exactly.
Just enjoy the show. Like, crowds used to be amazing.
Yeah.
Like, if you watch Attitude Era Raw's back, like, those crowds are like...
super good, yeah.
Yeah, they're like hostile crowds. They're cheering for everything.
Yeah.
Even mid-card, through women, through to the main event.
Weird. But yeah, the match itself, excellent. It's very, Seth Rollins put out loads of new moves in his arsenal. Very cool looking, like small package driver. Super cool.
Which is exactly what they called it as well, which was surprising to me.
Yeah.
I didn't know what it was, but I liked it.
It was super cool. into like a cool looking Phoenix Splash attempt, which Serpo counted. And yeah, it was good. Finn won. Yay.
Yay. It was, yeah, I really enjoyed it. I thought the match itself was good.
Yeah.
The only thing I didn't like was the crowd. But yeah, I thought it was great. I loved that Finn won, and I was so happy that he won because, first of all, I predicted it.
Yep, you did. I was wrong on that one.
Even though I sort of changed my mind because, you know, you were sort of thinking about it. Seth has been the one on ESPN promoting it and all that sort of stuff. He's probably going to win. But Finn won, and that is awesome.
So awesome.
And, you know, it looks like the belt was made for him because he was wearing red and
yes,
the belt just suited him, and it was great.
Yeah.
I mean, it shows exactly how much stock WWE holds in Finn Balor.
Yeah.
And, yeah, well, I mean, we'll get to obviously what happened next or the next night.
Yes.
You know, just in a short while. The main event was...
Nope, you missed one. Before that, then Wyatt was so far down in the card after both championship matches, but we had Rusev versus Reigns.
That's not even on here, actually.
It was not?
No.
That's funny. Well, to be fair, the match never happened, so...
Oh, that's why.
Yeah.
Yeah, you're right. The match didn't happen.
Yes, it was over. Rusev attacked Reigns before the match started. And then it's kind of a clusterfuck from there, really. So basically, Reigns got the upper hand, beat the crap out of Rusev to the point where he couldn't start the match because it was too hurt. And there's one more big spear off the ramp. And it was kind of dumb and stupid. And the crowd hated it.
Mm-hmm.
And CM Punk chants were there, because of course they were, followed by loud boos by everyone else who hates CM Punk. And yeah, the match was called off.
That's my section.
Yeah, that was you. Yeah, that was you. Boo, yeah.
That was literally me from home.
But yeah, this is why we had the match on War the night before, because, or the week before, because we didn't really get a match on the pay-per-view. It's stupid and dumb.
This is mindless booking.
It's so stupid.
Like, don't have the match on Raw. Have them beat each other up on Raw.
Yeah, exactly.
Then have the match in SummerSlam. It's just fucking hell.
Yeah.
How is it so difficult? Have your championship matches on the pay-per-view. don't give away the pay-per-view match. I know it wasn't for the championship on Raw, but don't give away that match on Raw before the pay-per-view. Have that crap that you're going to do at SummerSlam on Raw.
Yeah.
Then have the match, because you've built up more tension between the two and people are more likely to want to see the fight when they've seen that build-up.
Yeah.
Have that on SummerSlam. But no.
Weird.
No. Completely, they've lost me with it. I don't care.
Me too. Clearly. Also, tell we're looking for Roman Reigns. Roman Reigns just comes across as a massive asshole who just beats the crap out of his opponent and doesn't even care about the title. He's like, oh yeah, screw it. I'll just end up with my opponent for no reason.
Yeah, I'll just screw up my opportunity at this mid-tier championship that I don't even want.
After I've interrupted their wedding ceremony and threw his wife in a cake, I'll just beat the crap out of him, break his ribs or whatever.
Yeah, it's...
I'm a face. What?
It's really mindless, and people aren't buying into Roman Reigns.
Yeah.
You know, I thought this was going to be a good thing for Reigns, being in the sort of in the mid-card for a little while.
Should have been.
Let him sort of build himself back up. If he has to win the US title, win the US title, but have a feud with Rusev over it and win it eventually, whatever. Like Cena did.
Cena
spent time in the mid-card, did it well. Reigns could have done the same, built some faith back up, and, you know, pushed on from there, and eventually obviously go on to win the championship. But no, they've fucked it, and that's it.
Yep. But hey, at least we get to see it on War, right? Right.
Mm-hmm.
Anyway.
Okay, so the main event was one of the shortest matches on the card.
Yes.
And easily my least favourite of the night.
Same.
It was Brock Lesnar versus Randy Orton. A match 15 years in the making that nobody wanted to see.
Nobody wanted to see, and never really happened, really, did it?
Randy Orton tried his hardest to make this a spectacle.
Yeah. Yeah, it started off okay. Randy was coming across as like the desperate babyface, just trying to do what he can to survive. It's called looking RKO on the table, which didn't break.
Yeah.
Lol. Nice looking DDT through the ropes, followed by the RKO, who's got a two count. And after that, he was going for like the punt kick. We haven't seen for quite a while. He's got counted to an F5. And then Brock kind of peaked the shit out of him after that. Literally.
Yeah, there's literally nothing more you can say other than that. I mean, obviously the worked finish was for it to be a TKO.
Yeah.
So that Randy Orton technically hasn't been pinned and lost officially.
Yeah.
Because TKO isn't a real thing in professional wrestling.
Yeah, exactly.
At least not to my knowledge, but... No. But it looked nasty. There was, you know, there was an elbow that clearly did the damage, and Orton was bleeding everywhere.
So much blood, Jesus Christ.
Like, his head was just leaking.
Yeah.
It's like, when you saw him lying in that pool of blood, you thought, shit, is this...
Is this
a work, or...
Something bad happened.
So, you know, it's Brock is too rough.
Yeah, I didn't like seeing that. I had to look away. I don't like blood, honestly. I'm glad when they, like, stopped dull blading stuff, because I never liked seeing blood in wrestling. I don't know, maybe I'm panty, who knows. But
I used to like that. I mean, I'm not too bothered by it now. But, yeah, you know, but before, it suited that style of wrestling. But this is too much. I mean, yeah.
But before, to be fair, with the blade, it was never like gushes of blood pouring out of a guy's head, which is what happened tonight or on SummerSlam.
But it was real. And yeah. That was what the worst of it was. It wasn't a blade job, it was real. Like, because obviously, afterwards it showed like Randy sitting backstage and, you know, it's got a big dent in his head where Brock has basically caved it in. And it's just like, okay, when is enough enough? There are guys in the past that have been suspended or fired for injuring superstars unintentionally due to recklessness. Like, the one name that springs to mind is Ken Kennedy.
Oh, yeah.
He came back from injury. He was clearly going to be booked in the main event picture. Something happened on the Raw that he came back and he nearly injured whoever he was fighting.
Cena.
What Cena was it?
Yeah, it was like a botched, what do they call it? Arm thingy.
Like a forearm.
No, it was like a, what the hell do you call it? It was like a throw him over the shoulder kind
hip
of
toss.
Thing. Yeah, there you go. Hip toss. Bottom of those and yeah.
Right. And, you know, he was gone, never to be seen in WWE again after his big return.
Yeah, yeah.
Went to TNA, now his career's fucked. But, you know, he had so much potential. So, but these things happen all the time. Like, but this, I don't really understand how much longer these sort of things can be tolerated by WWE. I mean, I said it last week, and I say it now, Brock has WWE bent over.
Pretty much.
Like, right, I'm the big superstar, I'm the big crossover athlete, I'm the spectacle that people want to see. But... And that he thinks he can do what he wants because of that.
Yeah.
But now I think the tide is turning, and I think SummerSlam has changed a lot of people's minds.
Yeah.
I think it's turned a lot of heads in the sense of, okay, we like you, but this isn't professional wrestling. This is MMA that you're doing
here. Yeah.
Like, you've just split a man's skull open in the name of entertainment.
Yeah.
That couldn't have been planned. The plan would have been for the TKO.
It looked like it was legit. Sonny elbowing and baddie in the head. So, I don't know, what the hell? Maybe Brock has been a dick.
It's reckless.
Yeah.
It's stupid, and I didn't like it. Fine, if Brock has to win, he has to win, whatever. But there's ways to... do your fucking job. You're a professional wrestler. You're not an MMA fighter.
Yeah, seriously.
If you want to go and do MMA, go and do MMA. But you can't go and do MMA because you've been suspended for drugs.
Yeah. Yeah, this match made me not like Brock as much.
Yeah, I'm seriously done with it now.
Yeah, same.
I was sort of getting over it anyway, because I said to you, like, all he does is come in and does his suplexes, and the Dean Ambrose interview where he said he didn't want to do anything creative or artistic.
Yeah.
You know, that annoyed me about Brock, and it confirmed things that I thought anyway. It's just very arrogant, and it's a very very selfish way to go about things.
Yeah.
What I like is that, it's been doing the rounds on the internet. Chris Jericho sort of, you know, went to guerrilla position after to see what was going on, whether it was a work or whether Brock's gone into business for himself. You know, there was an altercation between the two backstage. Jericho really just sticking up for Randy Orton's well-being, checking to see if he's okay and if Brock's been a dick, basically.
Yeah.
And the two of them, you know, got into an argument backstage, which apparently Vince McMahon had to break up.
Yeah.
I've got a lot of time for Jericho.
Yeah, I love Jericho.
And apparently his stock has gone up sort of backstage after this. People see him as like quite a badass for sticking up to Brock. Yeah. Brock is massive in comparison, and he would kill Jericho.
Pretty much, yeah.
But it's nice to see that, you know, wrestlers do care about each other.
Yeah, yeah.
And I think Jericho, I'll take my hat off him.
Yeah, I love Jericho a lot. He's a great guy.
But I'm done with Brock now. I wouldn't care less if we never saw him again.
Same.
He's clearly going to fight Shane McMahon.
Oh, God. Yeah.
Because obviously, after the match, Shane came running down. This would have been planned. F5. Yeah. Whatever.
Yeah. I don't want to see that match.
I don't want to see Shane take a beating, I have to be honest, because that's what will happen.
Yeah. Weird.
Yeah. Okay. So, that happened. SummerSlam is a strange event.
Very strange.
What would you give it out of 10?
I don't know. It's a really good matches. But it was just wrapped in a weird vibe, I guess. I don't know.
I agree with that. It was overshadowed by Brock Lesnar.
Yeah. What's in the Goldberg?
Apparently, he's just had knee surgery.
Oh, is he? All right.
So he's sort of not willing to sort of come back just yet.
Fair play. I don't know. I don't know what you're about, Tommy. I feel like a 7 is too low because of AJ and Cena, but I don't know. I'd say 7 for now.
I agree. 7 out of 10. That's what I'm going to give it.
Yeah. But AJ versus Cena, very good.
Very, very
10
good.
10 out of 10 for them.
Finn versus Seth, very good.
Yes. 10 out of 10 for them, Joe.
Okay, so we move on to Raw the next night.
Yes.
The big news going into Raw that we're sort of doing rounds on the internet is that Finn Balor potentially got injured during his match with Seth Rollins at SummerSlam. That was confirmed on Raw, and the opening segment of Raw was Finn Balor relinquishing the Universal Championship.
Yeah, that sucks.
This sucks. Big so time sucks.
It's not so bad.
It just feels like it's unfair. It's like when Daniel Bryan had to relinquish the championship because of his injuries. And it just sucks, and I feel so bad for the guy.
Yeah, same here. It's all this hard work, and finally gets to the top, and it's like, yeah, I'm injured. 6 months off.
4 to 6 months.
4 to 6 months, yeah.
So that's a successful surgery, which is good.
Oh, good. That's good to know.
But it's sad, man. I'm really disappointed for the guy.
Yeah. Still, he barely gets it sorted out now than have it, like, get worse.
True. I mean, oh, yeah. I mean, he'll come back and he will get that run again.
Oh,
he
sure.
will absolutely get that run.
Yeah.
So, you know, that happened. What's sort of going on now is WWE have set up, it's going to be a fatal four-way on Raw next week.
Yep.
Four matches with 8 guys. That's right.
Yep.
Maths. And, you know, the 4 winners will be in a match next week.
Yeah.
Why they didn't say that, no way they could have planned for that on one night.
Yeah, sure, yeah.
They're like, shit, what do we do now?
Oh, God. Panic. Yeah, panic booking.
So we've got Seth Rollins, Kevin Owens, Big Cass, which is a strange one.
Super strange.
And help me out.
Roman Reigns,
of course. Everyone's favourite. They're going to be in a championship match next week.
Yeah.
So they had matches against, I can't remember what order, but Sami Zayn.
Sami Zayn and Seth Rollins.
Jericho.
Kay versus Neville.
Jericho versus Big Cass.
Russo versus Big Cass.
Oh, Russo versus Big Cass.
And Jericho versus Reigns.
Yeah.
The crowd was terrible in that match. Jesus Christ.
So those 4 guys are going to Raw next week and they're going to fight for the championship. Raw wasn't too bad this week. There's no point in going through the results. Let's just go through the talking points.
Yeah.
And how we see things moving forward from here.
Yeah. Number one, where was Cesaro? Why wasn't he in the title picture? Why Big Cass?
Well, he's in that series with Sheamus, and I don't think they want to disrupt it. They've made that bed. They haven't planned for this.
Yeah. Also, why is Roman Reigns in the main event again? He was just fighting for the US title. But he didn't have the match.
But again, this is WWE about to panic here.
Yeah, okay. Just throw everyone, all the big names in a hat and have them wrestle.
Yeah, that's basically what it is. It's like, shit, what do we do now? Our champion is injured. We can't just give the belt to Seth. Let's do something else. They would have had a whole program of this planned.
Yeah, that's true.
This is why I don't see Seth winning next week, but...
You don't see him winning?
No.
Oh, I do see him winning. Who else is going to win?
Kevin Owens. It's the right time.
I would love to see Kevin Owens win. You won't, but I would love to see it. Would like to make a bet for a prestigious...
Do you think Seth's just going to walk out with that belt?
I think so.
But that's just easy.
It is, and that's what WWE likes to do. Easy stuff.
Who else we got in there? Sorry, Big Cass.
Yep, Big Cass, Kevin Owens, Roman Reigns.
Why wouldn't it surprise me that Big Cass would win that match?
Oh, don't, please. that would kill any momentum Big Cass has. The crowd would just turn on immediately.
They would, wouldn't they?
Yeah.
They would. I think Kevin Owens will win it.
I would love to see Kevin Owens win it. Unless he would. But he won't.
Okay.
It might be in my estimation. So we'll make that a bet.
Okay.
For next week, I guess. Yeah. Great. Also, speaking of bets, I had an outstanding bet that Finn would turn heel by the end of the year. Finn is now injured and won't be back until next year. So what does that mean for my bet?
That means you've lost.
Does it though? But we don't know if he was going to turn heel. He might have done.
You've lost.
Oh, okay.
That's it. It's over for you. You've lost.
All right. You get an extra point.
Ding.
Well done. So, also, speaking of the points, SummerSlam. I had one more right guess than you did. I had one more point at the end of SummerSlam.
Okay.
One more right prediction. So that's a point to me, but I just lost it because you just won that bet. So who cares?
Right, good.
So I'm still 2 points behind, despite winning the SummerSlam bet. God damn it.
So coming out of Raw, we know what's going to happen with... We know what the WWE Championship scene looks like at the minute. Mm-hmm. We don't know who's going to win, but that is what it is. The US Championship, there's nothing further because both of them are in qualifying matches for Reigns and Rusev, whose program I assume will carry on after next week.
Yeah, probably.
Yeah, and Reigns, they'll fight again at the Night of Champions pay-per-view.
Yeah, sure.
Because Rusev's got to defend that United States Championship.
True.
So that'll carry on. The tag team titles... It looks like the club are going to get another chance for that, and they will win that belt, those belts, at Night of Champions.
They have to, surely.
They looked really strong on Raw as well, because they interrupted the Dudley Boys' big going away speech and beat them up.
Yep.
So they look very strong.
Yep. Although Anderson did lose to Big E during the night, which is...
But they stood tall at the end of the night.
Yeah, they did. That's fine.
So... That's that going forward. So the tag team titles, we know what's going on with. The women's title, Charlotte is the champion, as we know, coming out of SummerSlam.
Yep.
She was running her mouth in the ring on Raw, and Mick Foley came out and introduced the newest signee to the Raw roster.
Yeah.
Finally, Bayley made her debut.
Yay. Hooray.
She had an okay match with the still... pretty awful Dana Brooke.
Yeah, it was okay for a Dana match.
But I imagine that we're going to have Charlotte versus Bayley at Night of Champions.
For sure. And it'd be great, I'm sure.
Oh, it'd be excellent, yeah.
Yeah, people love Bayley. I love Bayley.
So the four titles on Raw are sorted. We know what's going to happen with them, and we know what feuds are going to happen going forward into Night of Champions, pretty much.
Yeah.
Fine. Okay, so Seth's got to fight someone. Well, whoever wins that Fatal 4-Way has got to fight someone.
Mm-hmm.
And I imagine it'll be whoever loses the pinfall against whoever gets the pinfall next week.
Yeah,
so we sort of know what's going to happen. So this is good. We have a solid-looking plan going forward. Also, the Cruiserweights debut are the Monday night after the Cruiserweight Classic finishes.
Cool.
Four guys have been announced so far for it.
Oh, yeah?
Noam Dar.
Sweet.
Okay, great news.
Awesome, yeah.
Top talent.
Yeah,
great. Rich Swann.
Awesome.
Massive fan of him.
Yes, so good.
The Brian Kendrick.
Awesome. I love me some Brian Kendrick.
And TJ Perkins.
Awesome.
So that's four guys confirmed. That's not enough to build a division, but it's a solid start.
That about the guys. I guess is Neville counts for weight? Is he?
I don't know what he weighs. It depends how they work in the weight division.
Yeah, true.
Because was it 205 to get into the Cruiserweight Classic?
I think so.
Neville has to weigh more than that.
Yeah, it'd be busy.
That said, that the guy who was in the Cruiserweight Classic was pretty big.
True.
Tony Nese.
Tony Nese, that's the guy, yeah.
Who has all the tools to be in WWE.
Oh, for sure, yeah, he's great. Yeah.
So it's a good solid base for the Cruiserweight division.
Yeah,
so definitely. Raw has potential now to build these feuds going into Night of Champions, which is about a month away.
Yeah.
Let's move on to SmackDown, unless there's anything on Raw you wanted to talk about.
I think that's it. What were we talking about? Braun Strowman's squash match against Johnny Knockout.
Johnny Knockout, what a name.
It's an amazing jobber name. Probably the best jobber name of all time.
Yep.
He was asked why he was doing this. He said because he likes big, sweaty, strong men. Good.
Good promo. Solid.
Solid.
So, they continue to build Braun Strowman. Don't think Nia Jax was on Raw.
She wasn't, though.
No, okay.
Week off.
So, That's fine. It is what it is. So Raw has a solid plan going forward, I think.
We think.
I mean, this is WWE.
Yeah, it's like it's very last minute, so they have to kind of make up as they're going along. But it's fine for that.
Yeah.
considering what they have to do, that's fine.
Yeah. So let's move on to SmackDown.
Okay.
So okay. The beginning of SmackDown is like a backstage segment with AJ Styles berating Dolph Ziggler and saying he was now the new face that runs the place because he beat John Cena.
Yeah, yes, John Cena's on man with him.
Yeah, and Ziggler and him had a backstage altercation. We all know what that was going to lead to.
Yeah.
So, fine. So, on SmackDown this week, they introduced new championships right at the top of the show.
Yes.
So, we've got a new women's championship, which is blue instead of red.
Yeah, Misty.
Great, right. That's simple.
Yeah,
do
that's what we need to do.
That is fine. It looks great.
It looks great.
Right, and the tag team titles have blue straps with silver plates.
Yeah.
Which look better than the Raw tag team titles.
Pretty much, yeah.
Right, so that's fine. Great.
Yeah.
And we have a solid plan as to what's going to happen.
Yeah.
Backlash in a couple of weeks. We're going to have a six-pack challenge for the six ladies that are in it.
Mm-hmm.
Becky, Alexa Bliss, Nikki Bella, Naomi, Carmella.
Yep. Natalia. Yeah.
Right, fine.
Perfect.
That's fine. You can build on that for the rest of the SmackDowns until Night of Champions.
Yep.
Good.
Good.
There's going to be a tag team tournament to determine the tag team champions.
Love these tournaments.
Love a tournament. Good. Solid. Now we know what's going to happen with the tag division going forward. Yeah. Wonderful.
Excellent.
What a great time. then Ziggler and AJ were just getting into it. Like, you know, and eventually a match was made. AJ Styles had earned his shot at the championship by beating Cena the night before, apparently.
Yep, that's fine. Makes sense.
Ziggler wanted a match. Yep. So they had a match, and the match was made. If Ziggler was to win, he would then be entered into the title match at Backlash.
Yeah.
He didn't win.
Of course.
So it's just going to be a singles match between AJ and Dean Ambrose.
Yep.
Great.
Awesome.
Now build with that.
Yes.
Fine.
Perfect. That's all you need.
Randy Orton was on Raw.
Yeah.
On SmackDown.
He Marty gash in his head.
Told us about getting the crap beaten out of him by Brock Lesnar. Then Bray Wyatt interrupted. We have a Bray Wyatt versus Randy Orton feud.
Excellent.
Good. Why? I have no idea why.
Yeah, why the hell not?
I mean, they had like an interaction last week on SmackDown.
Oh, they did? All right, okay.
But it just doesn't make sense with the rest of the build-up. It was weird. Because Bray was obviously interacting with Dean and Dolph, and nothing came of that.
Yeah, the week before that's true, SummerSlam, yeah. Well, nothing really happened with that.
He has some kind of interaction with Randy Orton. Now he's in a feud with Randy Orton. Fine.
Oh, yeah. Didn't they just, like, pass each other as, like, Bray was leaving and Randy was coming or something? Or vice versa?
Yeah, something like that. Yeah. So it was something...
And now I hate you, Randy. All right, sure.
So it's... That's fine. So we have clear direction for, like, the first time in a while.
Yeah.
So what would be brilliant is if Backlash was only 2 hours and they treated it like an NXT pay-per-view.
Yep.
Matches... for titles, great. Happy days. That'd be a wonderful thing.
So good.
So you could have the Divas, Women's Six-Pack Challenge.
Yep.
You have the Tag Team Championship Finals, which would be American, Alpha, and the Usos. You have the Intercontinental Championship feud, which there isn't one actually at the minute for that.
True. Think about one.
There will be one.
Yeah, for sure.
Okay, well, actually, here we go. This is where I was going to go with this.
Okay.
But I'll go with that in a sec. We've got Bray Wyatt versus Randy Orton. So that's four matches so far.
Great.
And a fifth for the IC title. Five matches.
Okay.
2 hours, 3 hours with a pre-show. Fine.
Yeah. That's what I need.
What I did like, they've turned Carmella.
Oh, yeah. Come on, turn heel. On Nikki, who came back as kind of a face heel. And now they've switched it over. I don't know. But yeah, come on, there's a bad guy now. She attacked Nikki during whatever that was.
Her in? And she was like, they were going to have a match.
Oh, yeah. And then she just... Oh, that's right. Yeah, Nikki was talking to Renee Young in the ring.
Yeah. And Carmella attacks from behind.
Yeah, that was it.
I'm absolutely fine with this.
Yep,
her walking to the ring talk wasn't resonating with the crowd at all.
Yeah.
They obviously needed to rethink their strategy. They have. And now she's a heel. And that's fine.
Yeah.
Because it's going to work.
Yep.
She doesn't need to be a face.
No.
She's not with Enzo and Cass on Raw, so it doesn't matter.
Yeah, exactly. But yeah, I'm totally fine with that. She wants to attack her again late in the night on Talking Smack.
Yeah.
That's cool. Awesome.
Now let's talk about Talking Smack.
Okay.
This show's going to get somebody in trouble 1 week. Guaranteed.
Yeah.
But for now, it seems to be a strong talking point every week.
Yeah.
This week, no exception.
Mm-hmm.
So Daniel Bryan is always on Talking Smack.
Yep.
The Miz was there. And Daniel Bryan sort of said that Miz was cowardly and he has a soft style of wrestling.
Yeah.
The Miz took exceptions to this. This is clearly a work.
Yeah.
Because WWE have tweeted it and they've put it on their Facebook and, well, they've acknowledged it.
Yeah.
This was a well worked shoot.
Hmm.
It was a worked shoot.
Well, yeah. Well, shoot. Shoot work. Yeah, work.
It was. It was a work shoot and that's fine. That Miz went off and on just on Daniel Bryan saying how he was a coward and he walked off and he left WWE. He went ballistic and he was brilliant.
Yeah, he's very good. Miz is a really good actor. Not him.
Yeah. So we are fans of the Miz on this show, as we said earlier on. But this is going to be a storyline going forward here with Daniel Bryan and the Miz having tension.
Yeah.
So Daniel Bryan's going to draft somebody in.
You think so?
Because he can't wrestle himself.
Hmm.
Who does he draft in?
Who would be good? Who would be a good Daniel Bryan guy?
Samoa Joe.
Ooh, that'd be good. But better be bringing in Samoa Joe as a face, though.
But Samoa Joe it matters not. They're two separate brands.
I guess that's fine. But I do like Samoa Joe. I would like to see him beat up The Miz. I must like The Miz. Maybe. I like it.
Yeah. That was my thing from early on. So I was like, Samoa Joe, if he's going to get called up to the main roster, he probably should go to SmackDown because the roster's a little bit thinner.
Yep, that's true.
That could happen. I'm not saying it will. I'm just saying he could go to NXT, get Samoa Joe. Samoa Joe doesn't have to be... He came into NXT as a face.
That's true.
And is now the biggest heel in NXT.
Yeah.
But he could go to SmackDown the same sort of way because the crowd will cheer him when he turns up.
Oh, for sure.
And then he'll turn on them.
Yep, eventually, yeah. But he win the title and then turn him.
That could happen. I'm not saying it could. It could be anyone. I mean, fucking hell, it could just be Kurt Hawkins.
Yeah.
Just bring Kurt Hawkins in and he could, you know, be Daniel Bryan's pick. Could be anyone. Could be Mark Henry. I don't know. Well, show Mark Henry's on, but it could be anyone. But this, Daniel Bryan will pick somebody to go against The Miz.
Yeah. That's not good. I like it.
Yeah. But The Miz was excellent, I thought. I mean, it was...
It was very good, yeah.
The whole internet was talking about it. Like, the whole IWC, which I hate the term IWC. Yeah. They were all talking about it. They were all really buzzing off this incredible promo that The Miz had done.
Yeah, saying, oh, was it real? Was it work? Was it shoot?
There's no way it was real.
No, it's not. No. But...
But kudos to everybody involved in that segment. Because it was awesome. And it's making people talk about SmackDown.
Yeah.
So now people are going to want to see SmackDown next week to see what The Miz and Daniel Bryan do.
Yeah.
What kind of interaction they have and sort of how it builds up and what happens with the IC title now. It's just building possibilities because I don't think, was The Miz on SmackDown this week?
I don't think it was, no.
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 But I don't know. It's interesting.
It's very interesting. Good stuff. Talking Smack. They're putting an effort in, modern. It's not just like another War pre-show where it's like, oh, what happened tonight? Oh, this happened. That's nice, isn't it? Let's talk to one of these guys.
I don't care about the Raw wrap-up show or the Raw pre-show or any of that crap.
Yeah.
But this...
Talking Smack is an actual proper like show to put effort in.
Seems like with Talking Smack, they're not giving scripts to read.
Yeah.
They're like, right, you go on this show after SmackDown and you're going to have to wing it.
Hmm.
You're going to have to go out there. Here's the idea of what's going to happen, but you can do it yourself.
Yeah, I like it.
I like it too.
Yeah, I think you're probably right.
But I am now excited again.
You do?
Because Raw was good this week.
It was.
SmackDown was better.
It was.
But I'm excited because we've got Backlash in a couple of weeks, which is new, and it's a SmackDown only pay-per-view.
Ooh.
So I think that's going to be really good, and I'm excited for that.
Yeah, me too.
And then we've got Night of Champions a couple of weeks later, which is a Raw pay-per-view, and all the belts are going to... That's how it should be. A pay-per-view should be all the belts getting... You know, defended in one night. That's how it should be.
I agree.
So, I'm excited again.
Me too.
I haven't been, but I am again.
Yeah, it's boys back.
Can't wait for next week when I'm sitting here like...
can't believe Backlash was so crap.
Sucks. Yeah. SmackDown was crap and they've done this and done this and Daniel Bryan and The Miz have hugged it out and it's fine.
Yeah.
They've got that doctor guy back and that's...
Can you imagine?
But yeah, it's exciting again.
It is. I'm excited.
Yeah.
Good. Wrestling's good. Even though it is, for now.
Don't jinx it. Just don't.
There's still too much of it, but it's good.
Yeah, so we've got NXT tonight and the Cruiserweight Classic.
Yeah.
But that's fine. I get excited for that. The Cruiserweight Classic is awesome.
It's so good.
Johnny Gargano versus TJ Perkins.
So ooh, that's going to be good.
Hell yeah, it is.
Sweet.
Sweet. Tweet. Okay, so we've rambled on. I knew this would be a long one because we had so much ground to cover.
Wow, that's flew by.
And we haven't even, we usually sort of run down the Raw results and the SmackDown results, but we've done it, I think, in a better way today.
Yeah, I think so. I like that.
We've took the talking points and we've condensed it and we've done it. We've Sonny and Finned it.
We've Sonny and Finned it. I like it.
That's the term now. We've Sonny and Finned it.
Yes.
Anything else you want to talk about?
I don't think so. I think that's about it.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay.
Cool.
That was episode 27 of the Sonny and Finn Show. Please do go subscribe to our podcast on iTunes.
Mm-hmm.
Go follow us on SoundCloud or listen to us on any other podcast service that you happen to use.
Yep, yep.
You can also find our podcast on YouTube. Please do go join other subscribers by watching our videos.
Yep.
Listening to our podcast on there and joining us for live streams as well.
Yes.
But for now, until next week, I'm Sonny.
I'm Finn.
And we're the Sonny and Finn Show. We'll speak to you next week, guys. Goodbye.
Thanks so much. Goodbye.